Stay tuned for the next episode.
Only here on V81 Radio, Manila.
Babalik na tayo sa ating portion, ang sabi ni Coach. At mga ka-rainbow, may expression tayo. Sige, narinig nyo na ito. With life gives you lemons, make lemonade.
Ay.
Diba? Na ang ibig sabihin ay gawing positibo at kapakipakinabang ang mga kahirapan na binibigay sa atin ng buhay. Ang tinutukoy ko ay ang katangian ng pagiging madiskarte na likas din sa ating kapwa Pilipino.
Pilipino.
Lalo na sa panahon ng kahirapan o pagsubok. Tulad ngayon, panahon ng pandemic, kung di lang tayo madiskarte ang karamihan sa atin, ay ayun, baka naubusan na tayo ng pag-asa, di ba? Ang dami ngayon, ang mga ating mga fashion designers nagiging artist, ang ating mga executive nagiging mga chef, di ba? Look how madiskarte we are in many aspects of lives.
Diba? Yes, tama yan, JV. I like the expression, JV. Naku, speaking of grit or discarte, buti na lang, meron tayong coach ngayon na magbibigay sa atin ng insight about how to make discarte, lalo na sa panahon ngayon. And I'm sure marami tayong mapupulot na lesson sa kanya. So, nako, ano, JV, Jonah, ito
yes,
na.
Kilala
ko na.
I'm ready.
Our coach guest tonight is a health and wellness coach, founder and chairman of the Frontliners 911 Rescue. O, di ba, very now, as in COVID. Yeah, he founded the Frontliners. And then, he's a founder chairman of Tikun Ulam Philippines Association. This Tikun Ulam is actually, they take care of the lepers, yung mga lepers. Ayan.
Mm.
And also, he is an author of a motivational and inspirational books. Ayan. So, I'm very proud to introduce to you our coach, Coach Ramon Mendoza. Ayan. Welcome, Polo Paso. Ayan. Hi, sir.
Welcome. Good evening to sir.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
How are you?
Ayan.
Looks good.
Oo, nako. May secret
ka si... Sa iyong mga followers, sa iyong mga viewers natin. At sa iyong mga baluwarto.
Greet ka muna, coach, sa iyong mga ano.
Amigo.
Alright. Okay. So, Coach Ramon, ang topic natin ngayon ay passion plus perseverance equals grit. Yan ang ating equation.
Oo.
Yes.
Okay. So, for me, those are three important qualities that will make a person succeed. The question is, how can we develop or how can we help ourselves to develop these qualities?
Yes. We really have to change ourselves first and try to study. Also with the help of mentors. And each one of us needs a mentor. So we must find our mentor so that we will learn how to really live this life fully alive. See, most of us are not really alive in terms of our vision. Oh, are we really living a life towards a particular vision? Or we are just taking space in this world of make-believe. So either we make it like that or we make it a reality. You need to find your strength because that's a God-given gift. All of us have weaknesses. That's why we are not really perfect. Only God is. That's why we need each other because everyone has a different strength. And together we become one. Together we become strong.
Being a leader doesn't mean you have to be always on the limelight.
Yes.
So sometimes you need to be in the background and allow your people or those under your care to shine.
Ayan. Correct. Ayan na. Ayan na ang ating ano. Thank you, Miss. Ayan.
Yeah.
So,
okay, so let's talk about this book of yours.
Actually, that is Actually, that's just for donation.
Donation.
Yeah, you can just. I don't receive any money from this. I give it away to the frontliners to save them from this pandemic.
Oh, big yeah. heart. Big heart oh, talaga wow. si engineer. Mm-hmm. Ayan, next slide.
E-download na tayo.
Okay.
Oo. So yeah, you could donate. Ayan, sa BPI. Soaring High.
So, Soaring High, yes.
Next slide.
Okay, next slide. If you really truly want to fly, you must give up everything that weighs you down. Meaning, there's so many things that are attached to you that is causing you to stay down. I mean, you cannot fly because of these people. These are mostly the negative ones. So you must stay away from very negative people so that you can fly. And normally, the winners are usually alone in flying. Usually the eagles fly alone.
Fearless. So,
according to Earl Nightingale, it's creative thinking. So I began to create things in my mind because what you see in the mind becomes a reality. I saw myself succeeding in this company and I did. Everything turned around. Now my boys are all graduates. I have a doctor. I have two professional photographers and one manager in a big company. Everything just turned around. And my friends, I think this is really truly the way. Building each other is the way to build your business. So the five core values that I decided to apply in myself are the following. I need to develop great relationships because without people, there's no success because success is always related to people around you. Optimized health, meaning we should be very careful in what we eat because we become what we eat. Social responsibility, I addressed that through my foundations and I felt joy. I felt happy doing it. And in terms of leadership, it's not about managing people, become a dictator, or telling people what to do. No. Leadership means to be a friend, to be a father, to guide you like a parent. And number five, to have your own mastermind alliance. Because 1+1 will be equal to 3. There is always a third person that is invisible.
Wow.
Yeah, ganda naman. So just that, include mo rin ang social responsibility and leadership actually. So ang ganda rin ng journey ni Sir Ramon, no? Grabe, nagkasakit siya. And then he, actually you could see that yung merong for life, that's his mother company. So he belongs to a company. Si Injury Ramon. Pero ang ganda ng mga tips niya talaga. Thank you, Sir Ramon. Thank you for,
Thank you, Sir Ramon, for sharing your insights with us on Rainbow
Sure. Time.
Ito, Jonah, ang ating Papi Love ngayon. Ay, balita ko ay... Well, actually, it's an airline pilot, di ba?
Sarap sa kill niya.
Oo, Jonah. Ito na, mga ka-Rainbow, our Papi Love, our guest for tonight, is an airline pilot and a senior first officer. Ayan. Wow. So, please all welcome our Papi Love for tonight, Mr. Arvin David. Ayan. Pasok, Arvin! Ayan.
Hi, Arvin!
Di ba, Arvin o Gabi? Mga Gabi. Nailove ka na.
Parang Otom Arroyo naman eh.
Ah, Otom Arroyo ba? Ayan, ako. Welcome, Arvin. Welcome to V81 Radio.
For inviting
me. Paano mo ba ma-apply ang pagiging madiskarte mo sa buhay? Kasi, di ba lahat sila dumaan sa medyo, ayun, ano ba yung grip o yung pagdidiskarte?
Actually, been there, done that eh. Kasi nung bata pa lang kami, hindi na stranger sa akin yung poverty. Yung poverty sa karamihan, alam lang nila by definition to Webster or any form of dictionary. But for us, sa family ko, we've been through poverty. So, we did not, hindi lang yung definition niya yung alam namin, kundi pinamuhay namin to eh. So, at young age, I'm supposed to be enjoying my youth, you know, playing. Pero hindi, nandun, tumutulong ako sa mama ko, sa karinderya, you know, nag-iigib ng tubig, naglilinis ng plato, you know, para makasurvive kami. Kasi doon namin kinukuha yung pang-sustain namin sa pang pampapaaral, pangbayad ng bills and everything. Mm-hmm. So, if we talk about diskarte, for me, parang magiging natural na lang kasi yun, lalabas yung ano eh, yung ano, you as a human, human being, yung instinct mo for survival lalabas eh. So, basta na lang, kahit hindi ka marunong ng ganitong trade, biglang lalabas na lang na makaka-adapt ka sa environment mo kasi you need to survive.
Ah, so actually Jonah nakakatuwa siya. Ano, sinabi niya agad 'yon na galing siya sa ano, nako tapos ngayon nasa Singapore siya. Paano ka ba nakarating diyan?
Kaya nga, 'di ba?
Singapore ko ito mga sa amin. Oo.
Pag-graduate ko po ng college kasi 1997 tapos it was tough times at those times because recession sa Pilipinas at sa actually sa buong mundo halos Southeast Asia tinamaan. So, wala akong makakuha ng trabaho sa Pilipinas. And then, naisip ko, dahil may kaibigan ako dito sa Singapore, may kakilala ako, tapos naririnig ko maraming trabaho. So, tulad ng karamihan na Pinoy, ay, pupunta ako sa Singapore. Magtutur kunyari, pero yung ano mo, yung intention mo, maghanap ng trabaho. So, ganun po ginawa ko at that time. That was 2001. Umalis ako ng Pilipinas. I was 23 at that time. And then, nakituloy po ako sa pastor namin dito sa Singapore. Pastor namin dati sa Pampanga, tapos nandito na siya. So, nakituloy po ako. And I was blessed because after three days lang, hinire ako ng isang company, aviation company, para gawing, because I didn't have any experience at that time, ginawa muna akong HR assistant for 6 months bago ako i-deploy sa mga projects nila. So yun, nag-tour, tapos naganap ng trabaho tulad ng ginagawa ng karamihan ngayon. Pero ang pinagkaiba lang ko, bago ako umalis ng Pilipinas, I really asked God, pinag-pray ko muna na, kasi it's uncertain lahat eh, pero pinag-pray ko na kung ito yung tamang path na nakaset para sa akin, then tulungan mo ako magkatrabaho agad. So, it happened po agad, 3 days lang.
Wow. Pero alam mo, salute to Arvin. Arvin, napakatatag mo. Pinatatag ka ng mga pinagdaanan mo sa buhay. Nahahasa ang iyong grit, ang iyong diskarte. At para dyan, 2 thumbs up for you.
Actually, grabe. Correct. Tama. Ang galing-galing. We salute you, Pilot Arvin.
Tell us in the comment. Don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with everyone you know.